Yo, what's up, guys? Well, we're back at the shop. It's Monday morning. I left my window cracked on my Del Sol just a little bit, and it rained yesterday. Whole seat was soaked, so my pants, of course, absorbed that. My whole back end is wet, so it's a little bit uncomfortable, but we're good. So anyways, I caught you guys up to date kind of with the C10 build a couple weeks ago, and we're also in the middle of putting in a paint booth. So there's two parts on that so far. We're about to film the third part, and we're still waiting on the city to approve the permits fully. I wanted to catch you guys up on one more project, and it's a car that I've had since I was 16 years old. It was one of my first cars. And I'm 33 years old now, so you do the math. It's about what, 15, 16 years? I don't know, something like that. 15 years. All right, I did the math. 17 years. I've had this car for about 17 years. I've painted it probably 3 times. I've had multiple engines in it, multiple turbos, blown up the engines, blown up transmissions, rebuilt the car several times. Actually, back in 2011, I converted it to right-hand drive. So, and in 2014, I tore it down and I was gonna redo the paint job one last time and rebuild the motor and everything. And basically since 2014, it's been sitting. Here she is. A few years ago, we were able to complete the paint job. The color is blazing copper pearl from Mazda's line. Inside the car, I did convert the car to right-hand drive. Japanese climate control in Celsius. We did a carbon fiber switch plate, Skunk 2 short shifter, ITR shift boot, and an ITR Skunk 2 shift knob. We have the JDM EG6 steering wheel. We have the Japanese speedometer. It's in kilometers. We have a universal right-hand drive gauge pillar pod. It has an oil pressure gauge, boost vacuum gauge, and a digital tach with shift light, which we're gonna get rid of this, and we're gonna be installing an odometer wideband. Now, I did do a hood cutout. We are going to install some lights. A B16 A2 engine out of a 2000 Honda Civic Si. Re-gasketed it. We did Gates Racing timing belt, did water pump, we did crank seal, did valve cover gasket, head gasket. I lapped the valves, set the valve lash, ARP head studs, NGK spark plugs, NGK spark plug wires, did new cap and rotor. We got some bunch of little billet type accessories, aluminum radiator. We replaced all the hoses, 2 silicone hoses and all the vacuum lines. GT35 journal bearing turbo. It's on a top mount manifold. A 3-inch exhaust all the way back. We're all V-band. We're tile external wastegate, which is also V-band. HKS blow-off valve, aluminum charge pipe kit, front mount intercooler. When I did load this car on a trailer, I did bottom out. We do have a new front lip coming, and it's on order. Should be here today, actually. We also have an upgraded spec clutch and flywheel. Hasport solid mounts. Skunk 2 replica intake manifold. A nitrous system on here. It's a wet nitrous system. And we have the 35 shot jets, which are going to be plumbed in, and we are going to spray nitrous on this car on the low end. Here's some of the other pieces that we still have in some boxes that are waiting to go on. We'll plan on installing these this week. We got 3 sets of spark plugs. Problem is, we are on a not, I wouldn't even call it a base map yet, but we were able to do a little bit of adjusting to get it to start. We're on a Walbro 255 fuel pump, and we're running 750cc RC injectors. So we got a few backup sets of spark plugs just in case. We do have the rest of the nitrous system we still have to install. So we got to mount the bottle in the trunk. We have the bottle heater, the brackets, some other nitrous parts, and the lines and the wiring for the solenoids. We just got this odometer wideband air fuel ratio gauge. We're gonna install that. We have some brand new sway bar end links for the front. Some new front lower ball joints. We have a little bit of a squeak going on. We have the oil catch can reservoir that we want to install. We have a lower tie bar that's polished that matches the rest of the strut tower bars on the front and rear that we've installed. This car does have the factory EXSI front brakes. They do have Brembo rotors, but we're actually gonna upgrade the brakes and we're gonna replace the rotors, pads. We're getting all new calipers, so we're gonna probably paint the calipers something fancy. We are gonna stick with these 15-inch TSW wheels. We have converted to rear Acura Integra disc brakes. On the back, we are gonna be running the Japanese license plates. We do have the 50-50 red and white tails. We do have brand new door glass, brand new window motors. This is a brand new windshield. We do have a pretty stock interior. Now the dash was out of a gray Civic hatchback, and one of the giveaways is it still has the rear wiper switch for a hatchback model, and this is a coupe, so it has no rear wiper. We were able to look up some paint codes and actually use the GM color as far as a GM interior color to mix up and actually use the proper chemicals to repaint the dash, and it worked out perfect. Another giveaway that this is a conversion is there is no handle on the passenger side, and there is one there. We also have the optional armrest from Honda, which features flip up armrest. It's got a cup holder and a spot for two tape cassettes. Pretty vintage. We got that brand new old stock. We also have the optional audio center console. Now that is the US optional audio center console that we got brand new old stock. All right guys, I actually am gonna put it up on the rack for you guys and we're gonna get a look underneath. So here, check it out. So it does feature the catback 3-inch exhaust. Here's the lower tie bar we're actually gonna replace to the polished one that's on the table there. They're a little dirty right now, but we're gonna be doing a full detail. So here is the Skunk 2 port shocks with the Skunk 2 sleeve coilovers. So you can see how big that exhaust is on this vehicle. And it's also V-band at the downpipe. We have a little bit of flexible section here. And of course the wrapped part. We're gonna put a little bit of wrap around this external dump tube. And you can see how tight everything is. You can see this oil return. We did just fix a leak recently on this. So we do have to clean this up and inspect this for leaks. It may or may not leak still. If it does, we gotta figure it out because we had a pretty good leak coming in from this oil pan area, and we just redid the gasket. It hasn't ran since, so this is kind of like old residual of the mess. So we're gonna wipe this up and clean it up, and that way tomorrow we'll get it running and we're gonna inspect this thing for leaks. We're gonna look over everything, make sure we're ready for street tuning. So you can see with that top mount manifold and that turbo, with all the charge piping and the oil return, that we are a tight fit. We do have power steering as well, so you can see how tight the fit is there. So what do you guys think? I don't know, it's kind of an old project. We are excited to get it on the road, excited to get it done. It's just time. If I let it sit around any longer, the car is gonna get beat up even more and it'll end up sitting outside getting rusted and rusting away. So anyways, that is one big exhaust for this car. Kind of wanted to just catch you guys up with what's going on with this car. We are very excited to get it together and show you guys the final product. So anyways, I just wanted to kind of catch everybody up to speed with this car. Stay tuned for some installs and the street tuning video as well. All right guys, we'll see you guys on the next one. Thanks, bye.